I can't believe it's June, and I am already going to be sharing with you the progress that I made on my Project Pan items during the month of May. If you're new here, my name's Tiana. I upload monthly empties, Project Pan videos, lots of lifestyle content, so make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified when I upload. And if you're returning, it is so nice to see you again. Make sure to go in the comments and say hi. I always love saying hi to you. And without further ado, let's get into the progress that I made during May. Last month, I didn't take any pictures of my progress because it was like I made progress on a lot of items, but it wasn't enough to show. So this month, I will actually show you like the progress I made, and I will also share with you the usage on all of my products. Typically, I apply makeup 8 to 15 times in a month, and that was pretty standard this month. And this month, the products are going to be so all over the place. Like, you'll see what I mean. But I will be actually bringing in 3 new products, which is going to be crazy. So let me grab my tally for my uses and we will just get right into it. The first item I'm going to talk about is actually the Infallible Pro Glow Foundation, and I am not going to be rolling it out this month. I honestly thought I was going to. I used this so many times in the month of May. I didn't even keep track of how many times I used it as a tinted moisturizer, but I use it as a tinted moisturizer, as an eye primer, as a concealer, as a foundation, and I still have some. And when I mean some, I literally mean a tiny bit. There's like nothing left in here. If I were to sit here and just let it all go to one side, you could see the bottom. I don't have much left in here. So this for June, it will be gone because there's basically nothing left in here. If I had one more week, I know this would be gone for sure. So anyway, I used it so many times as a tinted moisturizer, but for makeup, I used it 10 times in the month of May as like a foundation, concealer, and eye primer. And then I probably used it about 10 times as a tinted moisturizer as well. So let me tell you, this foundation from the drugstore, it lasts a very, very long time. So I would definitely pick this up again in the fall or winter because it is more of that dewy and radiant like foundation. So this, really loved it. Can't wait until I'm done it just to kind of move on to some different things. So again, I'm not going in any order. This is going to be the Charlotte Tilbury sample of the Rose Jewel lip gloss. I used this 12 times in the month of May. I probably used it around 20 times because I didn't mark when I would reapply it, but I did use this for like 12 days in the month of May, and it's done. There is nothing left at all in here. I finished it, which is amazing. I took the stopper out, and yes, it did get a little bit messy, but I worked my way through it, and I'm happy that I used this because it just means it's one less lip product. And now I can finally open my brand new one, which I'm excited about. This is probably one of my favorite glosses, or it is my favorite gloss. Like, I love it. That is why I bought the full size. I splurged, I bought it, and I can't wait to use it. But I did empty this, which means we are going to be rolling in something in its place. But I absolutely love it. The next item is from Merit Beauty, which I used 9 times. That's it. I know I just used it 9 times. I am not the biggest fan of this product. So this is the, I believe it's their brow pomade item, and this is in brown. And I put it in here because when I had the stopper in here, it honestly felt like zero product was coming out. It felt like nothing. And I honestly thought there was nothing left in it. I was not getting anything on the brush. It was so, so dry. So I took the stopper out, and that's probably the worst idea I had because now all the product is just going on the brush. But even when I look inside, there's still not that much product. The majority of the product is right here, and it's just super messy now. But what I will say is if I use this with a separate like spoolie and pencil to work on my brows, it fills them in and makes them look a lot better. I personally think they should just do like a pod and maybe not have the stopper so, so tight. This is not my favorite. I know this seems to be like a real hit or a real miss for some people, and I'm not able to like fill in my brows, which is annoying. So anyway, I'm gonna keep it in here. I'm gonna continue to use it, and then once I feel like I've had enough with it, I will declutter it and roll it out, but I feel like I can have another month's worth of this for sure. The next item I used was my Winky Lux brow pencil, and again, I used this 9 times as well, so I probably did my makeup 9 times in the month of May. So this here is almost done. I have probably 1 or 2 uses left of this item, and that's why I'm going to be keeping the Merit Beauty one so I can really focus on using that one. I honestly don't have like anything left on here at all. Like at all. This lasted me so long. I would not repurchase it. If I were to get it in a subscription box, if I were to get it like sent in PR, if I were to buy like a bundle of makeup and it was in there, I would use it. But it's not something I'd go out of my way and purchase again, just because it gets so hard with how big and wide the tip is to like get all of your eyebrows. This is good. I just probably wouldn't repurchase it. It's probably only going to be another use or two. It will be rolled out very soon, which is actually a lot of these products you're seeing, like they will be rolled out fairly soon, so that's good. I can definitely see this being only 1 or 2 uses, so I'm happy about that. Now the ColourPop Just a Tint. Let's talk about this one. So I used this 14 times in the month of May, but I did reapply it sometimes, so I would honestly say it is closer to 20 uses. And I honestly, I don't have that much left, but it is still a lot left because I just don't like the shade on me. It is just, it's just too pink. When you look at it, you may not think it's gonna pull this pink, but it does. And on my lips, even today, I did like a nice purple look and it just didn't look right on me on my lips by itself. And I don't know, it's just way too pink for myself personally. I may try and actually mark like usage products on the lid once I'm done a few of these, but yeah, this for me, I'm honestly going to do my very best to use this as a lip balm, to maybe wear it every single day in the month of June just to roll it out. So right now I have 1 lip product in my purse, 1 in my nightstand, and then I focus on this. So if I can maybe just not use the other 2 and then just use this, and then for my looks, even if it is just a little bit of pink and I can mix other products with it, maybe that's what I'll do. It's just, it's really not for me, this color. And I even went on ColourPop and I looked online and it did not look this pink. So I don't know. Maybe it's just my skin tone that makes it really pink. But anyway, it's just not for me. I'm gonna keep going. I don't have that much left. I'm really hoping to have this done. Once it looks like this and I can't like roll it up anymore, I will not be digging down. I'm not going in the stopper. I'm not doing that. Once it's done, it's done, which I'm really hoping, fingers crossed, June is the month. I'm really hoping. My glow drops, I ended up using 4 times as cheek products and then I ended up mixing it. So anyway, this, I can't get any more of the product out of the actual like jar. This is done now. I have tried and it's done. So I'm not done the product though. I actually ended up finishing a moisturizer and there was like a little bit left in the bottle. So I took the moisturizer and I mixed the remainder of the glow drops and this is what I'm left with. I tried so hard for 2 weeks to finish this and I just can't do it. This does have like coconut oil in it, so I do have to be careful if I put it around like my chest or my face because it will break me out. But the other part is because this is like shimmery and there's like a tint to it, if I put it all over my body, sometimes it can look a little patchy or very shimmery. Or if I were to apply it, let's say before bed and then put pajamas on, my pajamas the next day have like makeup or highlight on them. So I can only use this on small sections, let's say like on my arms, or if I'm wearing shorts on the rest of my legs to try and make it work. But anyway, slow and steady, I will get there. It will end eventually. I have just, there's really not that much left. Like you can see, like there's really nothing left in here. I really feel like June will be the month. I remember I set a goal for my butter bronzer. I really can't remember the goal. I feel like it was 4. I can't remember right now, but I do remember hitting the goal. So I used this 6 times in the month of May, and that was good for me because I just needed to know if I liked it or not. And I ended up dropping it and it is all crumbly and you can like, I don't know if you can see, but there is like the pan showing and okay, here's the thing. I don't want to repress this because I just don't feel like wasting my time because it is not a product that I really like. Not that the formula is not good, it's just not a shade for me. I will say this again. I went to the drugstore like 2 years ago. I grabbed the first bronzer I seen, I paid for it, I walked out the store, and this is way too orange for me, like way too orange. So I've been using this as a eyeshadow and it's been working. But the packaging is just so bulky, the shade is not for me, and it's crumbly. And I'm doing a declutter in July, and I have a feeling this is going to go. So I'm just gonna keep it as is for now. And if I reach for it, I reach for it. If I don't, I don't. It's really just not a product that I really care for anymore. I hit my usage goal, which is great. I can roll something else in. Now for like the really exciting part of the video. So because I am going to really be focusing on my ColourPop Just a Tint for the month of June, I really want to also work on a different lip product, so I am going to actually roll my Huda Beauty First Kiss Matte Lipstick in. This is my favorite. I have actually worn it in the month of May. Like, it is so, so pretty. I absolutely love it, and I do not want to use this up. Like, I don't want to finish it. That is not my goal. My goal is to just reach for this a little bit more because I'm really obsessed with it and I love it. I never want to reach for it, and that's a problem. Like, I should want to reach for it. So I feel like because this is a little too pink and this is matte, these two would be really nice because this is creamy, this is matte, and then this will cover this. That's what I've been doing. That's what I've actually been doing in the month of May. So my usage goal is going to be 5. I can use it alone, I can use it together 5 times. It's just so that I am reaching for it. It is going on a year old, but the formula is still great and I absolutely love the color. If I didn't have 2 products on my lips right now, I actually would probably put this on because I just love it. So anyway, 5 uses and then I will just roll it out. It's honestly just to use the lipstick. So the next item that's going to be a little bit easier again, and it's kind of just to replace my L'Oreal Pro Glow once it goes, is going to be the MAC Studio Fix Fluid SPF. I got samples from Sephora, and I just feel like for the month of June, once this is done, because it will be done, I'll just focus on these. I can use them alone, I can use them combined with a concealer, I can use them as a tinted moisturizer. So my goal will be to just use these. I'll just use them in the month of June, even if I mix this together, whatever works, but I just want to have these out only because it's just samples, so I might as well just use them. So I just feel like that's a good goal. I mean, 5 uses for this, use these samples. We're rotating through my collection, right? Using some products, getting some out. I feel like that's good. For the last item, I was going back and forth on what I should do, and this just feels right to me. This is the Candid Concealer by Revlon. This is by far one of my most favorite concealers from the drugstore. It is creamy, it is not dry, it covers very, very well. It has like a nice kind of dewy finish. I love it. And I want to put this in to finish it. The only reason why is because this shade is a little bit like yellow for me, right? It's just a little bit yellow for me. And I feel like now is a good time to use it. I'm going out, I may get a little bit more of a tan. I'm able to mix it with different foundations. It works more for me in the summer than it does the winter. And in the winter, if I want to get this again, I will just get a lighter shade. So I am going to keep this in here until it's finished. I finish concealer very quickly. Concealer for me will last me 4 to 6 months. That's kind of why I want to try the Too Faced one, because it is so big. But I love concealer. I love concealer, and it just goes very quickly for me. So I feel like I will be able to finish this by the time summer is over. If not summer, then fall. I know that I'll be able to finish it this year. So my update is I'm going to be rolling out 2, a usage goal and an empty, which is amazing. I can add this to my yearly empties. And I'm going to be bringing in 3, finish, and a usage goal. So I'm really excited about that. I feel like it's also going to give me just a nice refresh also, because a lot of these products have been in here for a really long time. I'm back. I know I look different. It has been a couple of hours. That's because my camera battery died. But anyway, moving forward, if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if you want to see when the update for this happens, make sure to subscribe and also ring the bell to be notified when I upload that video. I have lots of fun content coming up very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next one. Bye.